Hello students, welcome to our channel only for the students who are in the field of physical education and sports science. So today we'll talk about the SAI volleyball skill test. The SAI is the Sports Authority of India. They conducted a volleyball skill test in the year of 1992, and there are three items in this skill test. These items of skill test were made for the children of 10 to 14 years old. The three skill tests are accuracy of service test item, ball volleyball test item, medicine ball throw test item. Let's talk about the accuracy of service test item. The purpose of this test item is to measure the ability of exactness of service, the equipment, and about the court markings. See this court, the facility which is required, that is a mini volleyball court measuring 6 meter by 12 meter. So you can see over here that the length of the volleyball court is 12 meter, the width of the court is 6 meter, the pole height is 2.1 to 2.2 meters, and as equipment 10 mini volleyballs are required. Let's talk about how the test can be conducted. A subject is asked to stand in the service zone of the volleyball court, and using a mini volleyball, he or she has to serve the volleyball correctly over the net into the designated half. He or she is given 10 attempts, out of which 5 are to be serviced into the right half of the court and 5 into the left half of the court. So as you see in this animation picture, so here subject standing behind the end line, that is in the service zone area, and he has to serve the ball onto this court. The court is divided into two parts. Now the thing is that subject has to service the ball in underarm service procedure. 5 chances will be given to him to serve. First 5, he has to serve onto this court, right of court, and the next 5 service he has to serve onto the left. This is the procedure of the test. Let's see the animation, how the test can be conducted. In this way, he or she has to serve onto the court. Now what about the scoring? The number of services made correctly in the left and right half court is counted. The number of correct services is then converted into points with the help of SAI norm step. Let's talk about the ball bowling test item. By seeing this animation, you understand that the subject has to pass overhead the ball onto the wall. Now, what is the purpose of this test? The purpose of this test is to test the subject's control on volleyball balls. Let's see the equipment and facilities which are required to conduct this test. A smooth training wall is required, as you see in this picture. This is a training wall. There is a horizontal line at a height of 3 meters. This is the horizontal line, and the height of the horizontal line from the floor is 3 feet. One restraining line at a distance of 2.5 meter away from the running wall is marked on the floor, and as equipment, a mini volleyball is required. Let's see the video of this test, how the test can be conducted. You have seen the video. The player is required to stand behind the restraining line with the mini volleyball. The player has to throw the ball vertically upwards from the standing position and make volley pass on the training ball above the 3 meters high line. He is then required to make another volleyball pass vertically upwards when the ball rebounds from the wall and sit on the floor and make pass vertically upward over the head from the sitting position, and stand up to make a volley pass against the same cyclic order till his or her control over the volleyball without any drop. The subject is given 3 attempts and the best of the 3 scores is considered for evaluation. Once again, let's see the video. As far as scoring is concerned, each subject is given scoring in the form of number of completed successful volleyball cycles in a single attempt till his or her control over the ball. You have seen in the video first cycle and second cycle. I think you understand the first cycle. One cycle is constituted as by one volley pass and one overhead pass. That means one pass against the training wall in standing position and one pass above the head from the sitting position, as you have seen in this video. Now how the points can be evaluated? The number of cycles in the best attempts is converted into evaluation points with the help of sign-offs. For your understanding, the next test item is medicine ball throw test. The purpose of this test item is to measure the general throwing ability of the potential volleyball player. Now, the equipment which is required is a 1 kg medicine. Now, in this test, you have seen in the picture that a volleyball in his hand. This is only to show you how the test can be conducted as example. A measuring tape is required and marking powder. To conduct the test, medicine ball throw test, a field of 20 meter in length is marked in 1 meter intervals with the marking powder. Now, as the picture is taken in a roof, so this is just an example. You can see over here that a 20 meter line is drawn onto the floor and in 1 meter intervals with the marking powder, single lines are drawn. These are 1 meter distance. Now it has to be continued up to 20 meter. Now, how the test can be conducted? The subject is instructed to stand behind the throwing line, as you are seeing in this picture, as close as possible without touching the line. Then the subject is asked to throw the medicine ball as far as possible by keeping the ball behind the neck above the shoulder. The throw is to be made without taking any benefit to stop. We have a video which depicts how to test the throwing ability or how to conduct the test. Let me see. This video is just a demonstration on procedure of throwing. You have to conduct the test in an open ground where you can get 20 meter space. Once again, for your understanding. You have understood the test item. This is how this high volleyball skill test have to be conducted on the volleyball players. So thank you. Have a nice day.